Lupin Pharmaceuticals in association with Higher Secondary Principals Forum.
Good day, students. Welcome to the 12th standard. In the 11th standard, you had only one textbook in English language 1. It contained prose, poetry, reading and writing skills, and the supplementary reader. Do you remember? Hornbill and snapshots. At this level, in the 12th standard, we have two textbooks. One is Flamingo. May I introduce you to the textbook and its contents? Flamingo of standard 12 has two main parts. One is prose, the other is poetry. The prose section has 8 lessons. There are short stories, excerpts from a biography, an autobiography, a novel, from history, and books written by famous writers, both Indian and foreign. The poetry section has 6 delightful poems, ranging from the classical to the modern. They have been carefully selected to encourage you to enjoy the language of poetry. Let me now introduce you to Vistas. The second textbook is named Vistas and is a supplementary reader. The word Vistas means a pleasing view. The textbook indeed is a pleasing world view. We as readers are taken on a joyride to many countries, and we meet people, we visit places, we unravel plots, and enjoy the 8 stories with themes ranging from science fantasy, social satire, adventure, ethical moral issues, and personal conflicts. A literary treat, we can call it. Please keep in mind that while you must enjoy the stories, they are your subject matter for the tests and the exams that you will have to answer now and then. So, remember to have your own set of textbooks and notebook. The former is for reading with me and by yourselves later. The notebook is for writing keywords, key points, jotting down notes as you listen, a summary and questions from the internal assessment and from the board exam point of view. I am confident that you will enjoy this new form of study of this subject, English Language 1. You will learn much more than you could possibly hope for, and finally, you will do extremely well in your exams. Talking about tests and exams, I would like to inform you that the allotment of marks for English Language 1 Goa State Board exam question paper is set, and you must know it. It's a good idea to note down this information. The question paper is divided into 2 main parts, the non-textual and the textual. There are 3 sections in the non-textual part: Section A, reading skills. Section B, writing skills. Section C, grammar. And Section D is entirely textual, comprising of poetry, prose, and the supplementary reader. Percentage wise, it is 60% and 40% respectively. So, an 80 marks question paper is divided thus: 48 marks and 32 marks for non-textual and textual content respectively. The 48 marks of the non-textual part are allotted as follows. Section A, reading skills, comprehension 8 marks, note making and summarizing 8 marks. Section B, writing skills, notice writing 3 marks and report writing 5 marks. Question 5 is for letter writing 8 marks. Question 6, essay writing 10 marks. Section C, grammar, that's the syntax, 6 marks. And we get a total of 42 marks. The 32 marks of the textual part are allotted in this way. Poetry, that's question 8, there are 8 marks. Prose, that's question 9, there are 12 marks. And the supplementary reader, for which there are also 12 marks. I shall tell you more about the types of questions to expect in these 3 textual units as we proceed. Now, let us begin with lesson 1 from the prose section of the Flamingo text. The title, The Last Lesson. It is an extract from a semi-autobiographical novel by a French writer named Alphonse Daudet. Actually, it is the first lesson in our prose and poetry textbook for Standard 12, Flamingo, but it is titled The Last Lesson. The main theme of the story is language imposition and language loyalty. The story is set during a time of war when Alsace and Lorraine, two beautiful districts of France, were invaded by Prussian forces. And as a result of the invasion, the local language, French, would no longer be taught in the village school by the old teacher. Instead, a new teacher would be teaching in a new language, German, the language of the invaders. This was a blow to the patriotic teacher, Monsieur Hamel. The repentant village elders, the inattentive, disinterested students, and most of all to little Franz, the narrator of the events of the day. He is also one of the two main characters in the story, the other being the teacher, Monsieur Hamel. The story is originally in the French language. You will read names of people and places in France, learn their correct pronunciation. Take Monsieur Hamel, for instance. M is short for Masia. It is pronounced Masia. Just as in English, we write capital M, R, point, and we pronounce it Mr. It is the short form for Mr. So we must say Monsieur Amel, because the H is a little silent, it's mute. Make notes, please. You are capable of multitasking, right, side by side. If you flip the pages of your text, you will see the map of France, some of its important cities and its neighbors. Alsace and Lorraine are places located between France, Germany, Belgium and Switzerland. Alsace is famous for its natural beauty and as the place of origin of the dog. Alsatian, Alsace, Alsatian, remember? You see now? That's good. Now, shall we read the lesson? Listen carefully also to the explanation. The story has some main points. List them as we proceed. The last lesson by Alphonse Daudet. I started for school very late that morning and was in great dread of a scolding, especially because Monsieur Amel had said that he would question us on participles, and I did not know the first word about them. For a moment, I thought of running away and spending the day out of doors. It was so warm, so bright. The birds were chirping at the edge of the woods. And in the open field back of the sawmill, the Prussians were drilling. It was all much more tempting than the rule for participles. But I had the strength to resist and I hurried off to school. The story begins with little Franz hurrying to school as he is late. He is reluctant to go to school that day as his homework of studying the participles has not been done. There are many distractions on the way, but small though he is, he resists them. At least that's what he says. What were the distractions? Jot down the keyword distractions and quickly note the words that name the distractions. What are they? The warm, bright weather, the birds chirping at the edge of the forest, and the Prussian soldiers doing their morning exercises. Let's continue reading. When I passed the town hall, there was a crowd in front of the bulletin board. For the last 2 years, all our bad news had come from there. The lost battles, the draft, the orders of the commanding officer. And I thought to myself without stopping, what can be the matter now? Students, let's take a look at the bad news. You know, the town hall is just like the village panchayat office in our country. It is a source of socio-political news. Note down the word news, bad news, and write the three main headlines. Remember what they are? The draft, the lost battles, the orders of the commanding officer. What is the draft? When young people, especially young boys, are ordered to join the army, that's called the draft. And it's not always welcome. Let's continue now. Usually, when school began, there was a great bustle, which could be heard out in the street. The opening and closing of desks, lessons repeated in unison, very loud, with our hands over our ears to understand better, and the teacher's great ruler rapping on the table. But now it was all so still. Now let's take a look at the word bustle. Bustle refers to the noise of activity. Note the classroom activities that were responsible for the bustle in the classroom of little Franz. Opening and closing of desks, lessons repeated in unison, and the sound of the teacher's great iron ruler rapping on the table. The thing that surprised, I will continue reading, okay? You please follow in the textbook. The thing that surprised me most was to see on the back benches that were always empty, the village people sitting quietly like ourselves. And then he names the people. Now, everybody looked sad. The question is, on entering the classroom, why was little Franz surprised, and what surprised him the most? Let's talk about it. The teacher, Monsieur Hamel, was dressed in special clothes, which he wore only on days of inspection and on days of prize distribution. Secondly, there was total silence in the class. The entire school appeared to be silent and solemn, meaning serious. And what surprised him the most was the sight of elderly village people sitting on the back benches. Now, let's continue. While I was wondering about it all, Monsieur Hamel mounted his chair and in the same grave and gentle tone which he had used to me, he said, "My children, this is the last lesson I shall give you. The order has come from Berlin to teach only German in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine. The new master comes tomorrow. This is your last French lesson. I want you to be very attentive." This was an announcement made by the teacher. Now listen to this beautiful metaphor. What a thunderclap these words were to me. Thunderclap. They gave him a shock, you know. They gave him a start. And he was maybe frightened because he did not understand. Now, this is the language imposition that was mentioned earlier. You remember, I told you the theme of this story is language imposition and language loyalty. The order from Berlin imposing the invaders' German language, the expected arrival of the new master, the unwelcome news that day, that the lesson of that day was to be the last lesson in French, their language, and the one they loved. Let us move on. My last French lesson. Why? I hardly knew how to write. I should never learn any more. I must stop here then. Oh, how sorry I was for not learning my lessons, for seeking birds' eggs or going sliding on the Saar River. My books that had seemed such a nuisance a while ago, so heavy to carry, my grammar, my history of the saints, were old friends now that I couldn't give up. Now please notice, students, that each time the writer brings up three features, 3 points, three factors, you know, it makes it easier for us to remember. Now, a question that comes up is, why did little Franz feel remorse? Why was he sorry? Three reasons are mentioned. He had not been learning his lessons. He was more interested in searching for birds' eggs. And he had gone sliding on the river Saar instead of attending his class. Now he understands why the old men of the village are seated at the back of the classroom. Once again, he mentions these three reasons for their behavior. They were sorry for not having shown more interest when they were young. It was their way of thanking the old teacher who also had taught them, and it was their way of showing respect to the country that was theirs no longer. I heard Monsieur Hamel say to me, we go a little further now, I won't scold you, little Franz. You must feel bad enough. See how it is? Every day we say to ourselves, ah, we have plenty of time. I will learn it tomorrow. And now you see where we are? That's the great trouble with Alsace. She puts off learning till tomorrow. Now, those fellows, the invaders, will be able to ask you, they will have the right to say to you, how is it that you pretend to be Frenchmen and yet you can neither speak nor write your own language? But you are not the worst. And at this point, if you're paying attention, students, Monsieur Hamel, He starts blaming the parents and he starts blaming himself for the children not having done their lessons. I heard Monsieur Hamel say to me, your parents were not anxious enough to have you learn. They preferred to put you on the farm to work. So he talks about child labor, and he also talks about the abuse of school children when they are sent to do some work like watering the flowers, the plants, or maybe if the teacher wanted to go fishing, as he himself claimed. He says, when I wanted to go fishing, did I not give you a holiday? So he shares the blame. Then Monsieur Hamel speaks about the French language. Now, what he says about the French language is applicable to any language spoken by people anywhere in the world. When a people are enslaved, listen to his words, see what he says. When a people are enslaved, as long as they hold fast to their language, it is as if they had the key to their prison. He talks about the French language, calling it the most beautiful, the most logical, and the clearest. He says we must guard our language, and this is where the second theme of the story comes into play. Language, loyalty. Do you remember the first theme? Language, imposition. The second is language, loyalty. In the next paragraph, he talks about the kind of writing that was being done by the children in total silence. Please remember, students, that this story is from the early, from the late 19th century, and you know, the methods were, you could say, old. Little Franz is very attentive, so are all the children. And what happens as a result of his attention? He understands everything. Otherwise, he would say, oh, I have not understood what the teacher was explaining, forgetting that he had not been paying attention. And now, he and the rest of the school, they are doing their work, their classwork, they are very attentive, and whatever the teacher talks, they understand. Let's continue reading. We are almost at the end of our story. In this paragraph, the writer, Alphonse Daudet, the narrator, Little Franz, he gives you a character sketch. Not an actual drawing, but a drawing with words. He describes Monsieur Hamel, as he is seated in his chair in that classic posture, and he's looking out. We can almost see the thoughts that are going on in his mind. Listen to this, okay? I saw Monsieur Hamel sitting motionless in his chair and gazing first at one thing, then at another, as if he wanted to fix in his mind just how everything looked in that little schoolroom. Fancy. For 40 years he had been there in the same place, with his garden outside the window, his class in front of him, just like that. Only the desks and the benches had been worn smooth. The walnut trees in the garden were taller, and the hop vine that he had planted himself twined about the windows to the roof. How it must have broken his heart to leave it all, poor man. He and his sister must leave the country the next day. But he had the courage to remain till the end, to listen to every word of the lesson. Students, may I remind you of the play, the Browning version that you studied in the 11th standard? And a teacher, an old teacher named Mr. Crocker Harris, he had similar principles, if you remember. Now, the last key point in the story, the church clock strikes 12 and school is dismissed. That's what the teacher announces. Let me read the last part. Monsieur Hamel stood up, very pale in his chair. I never saw him look so tall. He had drawn himself together, you know, in an effort to remain very strong at this very last moment of the very last lesson. A lonely old man, clutching bravely at his loyalty and patriotism. At last, he gets recognition, but it is too late to celebrate. The last lesson is a story of regret at not giving importance to education and the learning of the local language. It is also a tale of triumph because Monsieur Hamel succeeded at the very end to awaken those who took for granted the precious things of life. There is a note of victory in his choking voice as he writes the slogan on the board, Vive la France. It means long live France, and in India we have a similar slogan, Jai Hind. So that was the reading of the lesson and the explanation. Now, I will give you a little summary which will be presented to you on the screen. You could read it. I would strongly advise that you make notes. You have learned note making and summarizing. This is where you practice it. Very, very briefly, the story is about the importance of one's own language. Little Franz, a student, and Monsieur Hamel, the teacher, are two main characters. Monsieur Hamel is forced to leave the school as an order from Berlin says that the teaching of the French language by a French teacher will be replaced by that of the German language taught by a German teacher. Little Franz is representative of the new generation of students of Monsieur Hamel, just as Auser and the other village elders are the older generation who passed out of the portals of the school long ago. But the scene has not improved. As Monsieur Hamel himself says, students are not fully appreciative of their linguistic heritage. The invasion by a foreign power has taken away their personal freedom and their freedom of expression. Only then they realize the loss, but by then it is too late. Still, it is hoped that realization having dawned on them, their language will not be forgotten, will never be discarded. The reader gets an opportunity to look at socio-political upheavals brought about by invasions, that too through the eyes of a little child. And now we look at the last part of the lesson, that is the questions. If you remember, I have already told you about the main questions in the question paper. I also told you that I will be telling you more about the questions of the textual side. Okay, so this is a prose lesson. So in the board exam question paper, it comes under question 9. These questions are of a factual nature. So the story content must be understood and must be remembered. There will be one question from each lesson among the seven presented in question 9. The answer has a word limit of about 25 to 30 words only, and 2 marks are allotted to each question. You can score full marks if your answer is appropriate and without any error. Now, you have 10 points in the story, and a question has been framed on each of those points. You could answer them when you have free time, or you could do them as part of your homework. These are the questions. I will give you a little time to write them down. Okay? So please note them down. Students, I would strongly advise you, please be active students. While you are watching this program, you are not just going to sit down and watch. You have to have your textbook, your notebook, and you have to keep writing. So hold a pen in your hand all the time and make notes. These are the questions. Mention any 3 distractions that little Franz had to overcome on his way to school. The second question, which news headlines were read by the village people at the town hall? Which activities, this is your third question, which activities created a bustle in the classroom? The fourth question, on entering the classroom, why was little Franz surprised and what surprised him the most? Question 5, which announcements of Monsieur Hamel had the effect of a thunderclap on little Franz? Question 6, mention 3 reasons why little Franz was filled with remorse on hearing about the last lesson. Question 7, which 3 reasons does little Franz give for the village elders being seated in the classroom? Next is question 8. Who does Monsieur Hamel blame for the children not learning their language and why? The 9th question, how does Monsieur Hamel describe a language of the people? And the last question, like the last lesson, give a brief character sketch of Monsieur Hamel. So students, with that, we come to the end of our lesson, which is the first lesson in your textbook, Flamingo, in the prose section. And what is its title? The Last Lesson. Thank you very much.
Prudent Scholars, powered by Lupin Pharmaceuticals.